Hi Sagittarius, this is your weekly reading starting from the 1st of May to the 7th of May. I'm going to look at this time period for you to understand what energies are coming in your life at this time. Around you in this time period is the Judgment and the Star. Judgment and the Star, and clarified by Judgment and the Star. So this means that there is going to be an influence of judgment and hope. So there is going to be some kind of healing. You will be hearing or you will be feeling a sense of satisfaction, resurrection from your past. You will be getting out of bad situations in this time period. You were in a situation which was giving you worry, tension, a feeling of setback, but now it is over with the coffin card. It is over and done with. There was for many of you a relationship or a marriage. There was a mature man who was connected with you, or a mature man was in the picture. The marriage, the association, it could be business association, it could be love situation, it could be some kind of worry because of a person in your life, a boss with whom you were associated, a teacher, a mentor. So this past is going away. Now options are opening up for you, and the major energy here is that you will hear some good news. You will be resurrected. You will be reconciling with a party. You will be doing a self-evaluation, seeing the reality, and hope will come to you. So you are emerging out of a period of Nine of Swords and Five of Swords, where you felt betrayed, where you felt a lot of worry, tension, and maybe for many of you, anxiety. In that period is over now, and with the Judgment and the Star, you are going to recover. There is going to be Three of Cups, so there is going to be some kind of upliftment, happiness, function, reunion of some kind. So what I feel is, for different Sagittarius, it is different thing. For some of you, it is a reunion with a person and their decision to come and meet you. It could be that there is a re-emergence and healing of some kind, treatment, or you are soliciting advice from someone, because there is Hierophant here. Some mentor-like person is coming in and giving you some advice. So healing is reigning in. Some kind of fair judgment will be done. Some information will be heard. Some intervention will happen that is going to give you a new hope. So in a relationship, there is reunion, reconciliation. In a work situation, you will hear about a job, an opportunity which you were looking for, a growth you were looking for. In terms of family, you are reuniting. So there is this energy of, meeting or having a conversation or some kind of upliftment in your life. There is a Aquarius, Libra, Gemini energy around you, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces energy around you. And in this week, you will feel self-reliant with the Nine of Pentacles and the Seven of Wands. You will be in warrior-like energy. You will be a bit defensive. You will be on the higher ground. You will be trying to achieve your targets and handling your challenges meanwhile. So whatever you are doing in your life, there is going to be a divine intervention that is going to influence your day-to-day activity. There is some kind of protection. This could be planetary, this could be your luck, and this fortunate situation is going to give you a warrior-like attitude, some kind of flair in something. Some of you could be playing a sport and becoming a star. So you never know what is going to work for you, and the judgment will be in your favor. You could be selected in a team, you could be selected in some kind of performance, some kind of theater group or performance of some kind, getting a role. So it can be anything. So an opportunity is opening up and you will be hearing the news. So in terms of love, this means, you know, communication, this means positive things, it means reconciliation and getting back together. With the Lovers card and the Six of Cups, what I am seeing is great harmonious decisions in love and partnership will take place. Some of you are going back to your exes, some of you are getting back together. That is what I am seeing. But Sagittarius, one thing troubles you, that is the obstacle, Eight of Pentacles obstacle. So this means that some of you need to correct something and you are not listening to advice. So you got to overcome this weakness. This weakness is not for everyone, but slightly in different shades every one of you might be going through this issue of not listening to others and doing what you want to do. So there is a guidance that you need to listen to a bit of advice. The Prince of Wands or the Knight of Wands is in your advantage and it is telling you that this week you need to take new initiative, you need to change your gears, you need to go for things which you have passion for and you are going to win. So there is energetic you who is in advantage in this time period. So there will be situations of advice. You will be counseled by someone or you will be seeking counseling. There can be, with the Knight of Wands in advantage, there can be journey or shift. There can be going towards something with a destination in mind. Also, there is lot of meeting, talking with the family room energy, with people close to you. Occupation or skill is very important at this time, and that is what is in the question, or it will be what will occupy you all through this week. The Lovers card here is telling me good partnership, love, and some of you having great soulful friendships. Where there is one person who is very significant, could be a romantic connection, might not be a romantic connection, but this love is undoubtedly the best love. So it is there. Wealthy man could be a person supporting you, someone rich, someone powerful, influential, supporting you in this time period. So your outcome is the Wheel of Fortune. This is also identification of Sagittarius and Ten of Cups. You have gotten Ten of Cups. You will get Ten of Cups. Your outcome is that you will be in King of Wands energy, who will be in the fighting mode, who will be dealing with all their challenges, keeping their higher ground. So whether it is your sports, whether studies, whether it is a job, whether it is in love, you are going to reach great heights and you are going to have some journey, some travel, and movement towards a leadership position. That is what I am seeing. So great energy is coming to you. So let's read out one planetary card, that is the transits card that I am getting. So let's understand what is transits. So in this situation there is a flux. So flux means change, and thus surrounding conditions are changing. So you don't have control over your changing conditions. Stay alert, aware, and be ready to respond. So response is very important. So whatever is coming towards you, danger or opportunities, you have to be in response mode. Some people are moving in, others are leaving. So some people are moving in, others are leaving. New opportunities open and old chapters closed. Listen to the grapevine for changes in personal or economic conditions. You are not in control of these elements, but you can make the most of these changes and dance with fate. People that walk into your life now may be karmically important. Either the relationship will last a long time or it may be short, pithy, and teach you a valuable lesson. It can be helpful at this point to look at transits in your natal chart. There is no volume control on the card's energy. Transits may trigger a small change in the personnel around you, or it could signal a shooting star that blazes across your life and turns your direction entirely. You have choices. So what I am seeing is, you know, a change towards great hope and, you know, healing and reconciliation and resurrection in this time period. So the gift of this card, gift of this transit, is life is ever moving and you do not have control over people and events transiting your life, but know that you are in complete control of your response to the transit. And the problem is that there could be things at play which you cannot control in this time period. So this is very a period of period where things are unknown to you, but you will be having some kind of protection, or there can be great growth in this time period. So let's read out another card, that is the Spring card. The Spring card is telling us embrace the change. That is I think my eyesight is weakening. Embrace the change that is on the horizon. Allow your dreams to become reality. You are ready to bring to life all of your ideas, inspiration, and projects. When the card appears, you are moving into a space that allows you to really grow, expand, and create a way you have never done before. There are opportunities for abundance, including financial growth. And if you are starting something new, prepare for a major expansion in your life and your soul. When the Spring card comes in future position, which actually came in your last as a last card, and the future position, it is telling us that coming spring will usher in important energies with regards to your questions or intentions. So the coming spring could be, you know, this time period or the next year. So whatever is coming to you is going to be of great value, and it is going to change your direction entirely for many of you. But what you need to do is to work on this soliciting advice, seeking advice. That is important. So exchange of ideas, meeting with people and listening to them is very important in this time period. So if you have liked this reading, please like and subscribe. If you have any personal issues, you can come for a personal reading. These readings are prepaid, pre-booked, and pre-slotted. So you can write to me. My email ID is there in the description box. The membership link is also there in the description box. If you want to remain in touch with me, you can take membership of the channel and have access to me. You have to write in any case, whether you take a membership or whether you just want a one-off reading. So whatever it is, my email ID is there. You can contact me. And please do comment. I read all the comments. I usually try to reply, but sometimes I get busy. So always wait patiently. I will reply to you if there is a query. So that's it. Please enjoy these readings which I post for you. Now I have started posting weekly readings. I used to post next 10 days reading, now next 7 days. So thanks for watching, every one of you. And I wish you all the best. Bye-bye.